To the Blue Jackie!
Hello, hello everybody, this is Jack, and welcome back to a brand new live stream. Oh my goodness, sorry, I warned the stream started a few, like, half an hour ago, but it didn't. So, yeah, I'm sorry about the false alarm. Yeah. It happens. We'll roll with it. So this is the first time since forever that I used the non-scheduled chat. That's why I had the mistake. So I, like, there's a section, if you're a YouTuber, you know about the live streaming probably, and there's the events, and there's the live the stream now, and this is the stream now thing. So we'll see how this goes. I see a lot of people on stream today. I see Leonard, I see J-Rod, I see Jobless Tuber, Sonic, and of course Juan Schwartz, which will be part of the stream today as a co-commentator. Hello, Juan! How are you?
Yo!
Awesome.
What's going on?
So can you guys hear us well? Are we cool? Is the sound all right? Is the music too loud? Let me know all that before we start the stream. Nope, I'm not feeling sick.
Buttery.
I'm not
smooth.
Feeling sick. Buttery and smooth.
Like butter.
Like butter. I don't think I changed anything. Maybe it's me. I'm probably doing a deeper voice today. Maybe because of the position I am at. I don't know. I'm getting old.
Yeah, that's really it, though. At the end of the day, that's the answer to everything. Is we're fucking getting old.
Oh, that's right.
Every single
that
problem
is totally
that we've
right.
attributed to the fact that we're just fucking getting old.
Let me just adjust the chat. There's going to be some chat adjusting, by the way, because this tricked me. As you could see at the beginning of the stream, it said no video shown. Oh goodness. Wow. There you go. Chat is all ready to go.
Red to go.
Red to go. What time is it? Let me check out my clock.
It's 24 on my side.
We have 5 minutes. We have my 5 minutes to start up the stream for real. So, guys, awesome. Thank you for coming. Don't forget to check out the t-shirts we have for charity. Part of the money will go for Child's Play. Don't forget to get yours. There's going to be a few that will come in the future, so don't worry about that. You'll have more choices in the future. But it's not only about t-shirts. There's also mugs. There's all sorts of things you can buy there. So it's cool. There is also... We have also a Patreon page, which Leonard Clements is one of the Patreons today. There. So thank you so much for those who have supported the channel in that way. Aside from that, well, today is Shantae, Half-Genie Hero. But wait a second. Are we going to finish this today?
I think there's a very good chance that we will finish it today.
It's the third stream. That's quite short. We'll see. We'll see if we can put it all up in a two-hour stream, or if we need to create another one. Either way, no problem.
I mean, it could just be me. Like, I've, you know, blasted through this game so many times that I could get it done in probably an hour or less. So I sort of imagine we could, but maybe not. You know, maybe I'm just, you know, talking out of my ass. I don't know.
It can't happen. But the thing is, I also go a little bit slower because I'm discovering the things for the first time. So yeah,
exactly.
It might also be because of that.
Yeah, I haven't played the game with like another person, so like as far as what pace, you know, they would be going. In this case, you, I don't know, because I haven't played the game for the first time in what, 2 months, three months, 2 months.
Hey, started playing like really early. Actually, you backed the game, so you got the backers demo, right? The backers, not demo version.
I sure did, but I didn't actually start seriously playing it until it was released.
Okay. Did you notice any glaring difference between the two versions, by the way?
What was that?
I was asking if you had noticed any obvious difference in between the two versions. The backer version and
Yeah. Yeah, not really. Mostly just like this animation.
Is it me or your internet is acting up?
Your voice is cutting up big
time. Oh boy.
Still understand, but
wait.
I'm sure about this.
Let's do the call again. Wait a second. Excuse me for that.
Bye.
Hey. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Can you hear me?
What's going on? Right. I can hear you. We're good.
Yeah, cool. Awesome. Your internet was acting up or something. The call was like weird. All right. I guess we should get started right now before the internet starts acting up again.
Indeed.
All right. Let's go then.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is your captain speaking. And if you look out your left window here, you can see some Shantae Half-Genie Hero. Okay. And, you know, put your fucking tray table up and sit in the upright position, you stupid bastard.
Ha! Let's roll the intro.
Let's do it. We got some genie magic.
Okay, sorry for one thing. first of all, before we continue. There's going to be that little annoyance in the corner, which is basically the voice chat. Let me see how I can, like, remove it. Control Alt. What? Space. Control Alt Space. Can I disable that?
It's a Mr. Mackey. Jobless Mr. Mackey.
No, I can't disable it now. What? Ah, I hate that. Ah, boy.
I don't know where the exits are. There are no exits.
There are no exits. No escape is possible.
Yep, this is it. This is where it all ends.
And the chat is on now, I hope.
It all ends here, in the darkness.
The darkness.
Yep.
Let me know if the sound of the game is too loud. I guess it is, just a little bit. Ah, oh, that's better now. To my ears.
Okay, Jack, we're gonna play some Shantae, okay?
Okay. We're gonna play Shantae, well. Okay?
I can do the okay really well, but that's it. Like the rest of his voice.
Is that better now? Can you hear us clearly? Hardcore mode.
Hardcore mode is awesome, dude.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and you know what? I wanted to get this out of the way right away, because when we did the stream last week, we were talking about how the mouse bite is useless, right? It's like, mm-hmm. Oh yeah, the mouse bite is useless. It doesn't even work on the centipedes inside the wall. Like, the only enemies that you really encounter as the mouse. And we were kind of laughing about that, like, oh, it's useless and blah, blah, blah. The game was updated, like, while we were playing, basically. And
oh, really?
Yeah.
So the mouse bite is now useful.
The mouse, as soon as I jumped on the game, which was right after we had stopped the stream, the fucking mouse bite was working. It was awesome. It was like, I swear to God, like, WayForward has my house bugged. Like, they heard about it and they fixed it right then.
Oh wait, it was great. We're watching that dude's stream and that guy said we need to fix the mouse bite. Quickly, code it!
Yeah, no shit. It's like, oh fuck, we forgot about the mouse bite. I mean, all right. If you wanted to bug somebody, all right, go ahead.
No. Please finish your thought real quick.
If they wanted to bug somebody and, like, you know, sort of just find out what the average Shantae player would be doing, I would be a pretty good one to do. Well, then again, I'm not the average Shantae player.
That's true. You're much more than the average. You actually play a lot more than anybody else. Well, right now I'm playing the game, and I am going to go back to Mermaid Falls.
Indeed.
And we are going to collect the things there. Is that a good move?
That is a good move. We got the candy, right, from the doctor? Yeah.
Yes, we have.
We did. Okay.
So we're ready to go. Save complete.
Ready to go. We got a few things to get here.
My dude, this quality is gorgeous. I'm watching the stream right now at the same time, and it's just wonderful. I'm too proud of myself. Those gorgeous 1080p, 60 frames per sec.
It looks great, definitely.
Yeah. Should we kind of, like, I don't know if there's anything down there. Wait a second.
No, there's not. Well, down there, there is. There's a few things. Right now, though, let's kind of focus on... Oh, not over there. There's nothing over
okay,
there.
Okay, there's nothing here. Okay.
No. Back to where you were. I would say let's focus on... You got the harpy
on...
last stream, didn't you?
Nope. No harpy.
You know what? That's true. That's right. Because we didn't do the...
And no bubble, okay. Either.
Well, we still do some shit. Try heading up here to the top left of this area.
The top left of this area? So we're... Yeah. Are we talking about what transformation right now? What transformation are we going to use?
We got a soul right there. We're going to head all the way up to the top left, and we're going to use the bat.
This animation is too fast.
So I was sort of thinking of the harpy, because that's what I use to get up there real quick. You can use the monkey and get up there pretty quickly.
That's what we need to do, actually. We gotta start up there, right?
Yeah, you gotta take the crab down there.
Okay.
There's a couple things to do underwater.
I don't think I can do anything else here. I gotta go around now. I'm gonna try to collect as much as possible with the crab right away.
There's nothing you can really do with it right now.
Let's go. Let's ignore this. We'll come back with the... I'm pretty sure we need the bubble.
Yeah, right? To really do everything here.
Crap. This is too fast. The metronome thing. Oh boy. Oh boy. Okay. Nice. Nice, nice. Let's go up. Let's see if we can... I'm gonna keep the monkey. See if I can go as high as possible.
You just want to get really, really high when you play Shantae. Yeah, right here. You're gonna have to go across and then up. Across here.
Mm-hmm.
There's a portal above you. You can't do anything with that yet.
Okay, keep going up.
Keep going up. You should see. There's a platform.
Basically, follow the patterns, right?
Yeah, keep going. There's a platform jutting out by itself of the wall here. That one right there. Turn it, that little platform down there, not that one, not the moving one.
Okay. We're delayed. Sorry. I'm going back. Okay. Platform. Wait a second. I went back, but I... Okay.
There's that little platform. It doesn't have a maze on it. It's just that little thing poking out right there.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And what should I do?
That's the one. Just right below... Fucking delay, man. Alright, turn into the bat net and go all the way across.
Oh, okay, I see. Oh, boy, that's not the bat. Thank you.
That's that fucking naga.
The transformations are way too quick. I should... Like turn off the I'm gonna turn off the metronome. Yeah, I'm gonna turn it off. I like it fast, but it's too fast. I'm not used to transforming, like, you know.
Yeah. And now that we've got
the mouse, you can destroy them.
Indeed.
Awesome. Oh boy.
Okay, this is your captain speaking, and now that we've got the mouse, we can do some interesting shit. We can bite this centipede, motherfucker, and get some treasure, too. Okay,
and
we gotta
fall off the thing, too, apparently.
We can fall off. Be sure not to do that.
I fell off. That's why I'm saying.
Yeah, we gotta go all the way back and use the bat.
Oh, you gotta be joking. That's why it's going to take two streams for me to do that.
Yeah, that's what'll do it. You're right. I didn't factor in that kind of shit. Maybe I should have.
Got some sort of message I can't see, obviously. All right. Let's wait here for the platform to come.
Indeed. You're gonna fuck around in this maze for a minute.
Come on.
Got a and a heart holder.
Fell again.
Fine.
We'll be back when I actually do this right.
Yeah, we're just gonna edit the footage together here.
Yeah.
Never fallen out of this fucking maze.
Just letting you know it doesn't work.
Yeah.
Metal Sonic, welcome to the stream, of course.
Metal,
it's way too fast. Now without the metronome, I can actually transform properly. It's good when you want to speedrun and you know exactly where to, you know. Oh, I actually didn't realize that, but okay, that makes much more sense now. The mouse goes on a straight line. You don't have to keep the button pressed. It just goes.
Yeah.
It's like Pac-Man.
Yeah, more or less.
Okay. I didn't know that. No, I'm not gonna fall anymore, because I know it. Dang it.
Thank God.
Okay, first of all, let's get this chest here. Oh, we found the key. Another gallery key, awesome.
Another gallery key. We got a heart container coming up here, too.
Awesome. That's what probably we're gonna get right now. Let's see.
After that, you can get out of this maze. There's nothing. We're gonna have to go to a different maze.
The mouse bite is overpowered now.
Yeah. Fucking mouse bite is OP, dude. We gotta nerf that shit. It's too useful.
I always believed that the mouse bite would be useful for stuff like this. And like a maze if there's any enemies or stuff. Because that's the only moment you actually use the mouse, right?
Yeah.
Like you said, like in the... In the last stream, you said it's... Oh, and the mouse bite helps you go faster. I didn't know that.
Like the fucking shit. Like, you had this mouse bite and it wouldn't work on these little centipede things. They were the only enemies that you mouse. And it just drove me fucking crazy. But they fixed it.
It didn't
right
make any
after.
Sense.
Amazing, yeah. Fucking amazing. I mean, I was... quite visually ecstatic about it. Visibly ecstatic.
Visually? That was the
visually
good word.
Ecstatic.
Heart holder! And
indeed. You can take the left here and get it the fuck out of this maze. You're pretty much done in here. There's another maze that you need to get into over here. And it's kind of in the middle of the area. It's down here. There's probably a Naga on it. It's got a waterfall running right through the middle. And there will be a little hole at the top that you can jump into.
Okay, let me see.
I think it's right across here, actually. Or just right around here, I think. Yeah.
I think I understand where it's going to lead. Okay,
yeah, not that one,
it.
Though.
It's above me.
That one. Not that one. No, you're good. Just keep going left, and it should be that one right there where that Naga is. Yeah, go right in there.
Weird.
So where the Naga
kinda.
Was?
Yeah, I saw it.
Okay.
Sorry, I was looking up because that was where we are going to go, and it was actually right below my feet for a second.
Yeah, that's gonna take
to
you
go...
all over. Yes,
do we need to go right at any time?
No.
All right,
sure
cool.
Didn't. We are going to be lifting it up. Up in
yep.
This piece today.
Oh, and by the way, FYI, for those who are wondering how the mouse bite works, if you press B and don't move, it stays in place, right? But if you if you're moving, the mouse kind of leaps forward, goes a little bit faster, and avoids the enemy attacks. So it's awesome.
Indeed. It is interesting, Luigi. I thought it was a cool little idea.
Luigi,
sort of
I didn't notice you were here. Hello. Oh, hi.
Yeah, having a mouse transformation doesn't seem that cool at first, but then you see, you know, stuff implemented like this, and it's a pretty unique idea, so... Yeah, we're gonna get our light shard from this guy.
Got any candy? Mm-hmm. We have candy.
This guy's out of his fucking mind.
Have some. Take the lollipop. Oh, I mean, wow.
Okay. All right, now we're going to go into the next area here. We're kind of done in here right now.
So, the tunnels at right next to us, the transport gate on the left is not for now, right?
It's not for now. We're going to come back here one final time later on.
There you go. So if you need to get out, use the elephant. That's all. I can just exit the level right now?
No. The next area, we got a few things to get.
Okay. Cool. Oops. Oops. I used the restoration dance. I'm dumb. Oh, come on. All right.
You've got no rhythm.
Yeah, next area. That's it. Warp dance. Oh, goodness. I'm all over the place.
Haven't you ever belly danced before? I mean, Jesus.
I'm not... Luigi, by the way, I'm not reading the chat too much because I'm playing on my TV and the chat doesn't appear right in front of me. So, I can't read, like... I'm not reading all the time. And so that's why I don't notice people coming in and leaving, sadly. I wish I could, It's a trade-off. I either pay attention to the game or, I should do this to the flowers, actually.
Yeah, one of these flowers is gonna give us some scrap metal.
There must be a flower on the other side that I missed. Nope.
No, keep going.
Fine.
There's only one that's got scrap. There's one sunken soul that you need to get in here, and it should be, I believe, right in the same area where the flower is that you find the scrap metal. So, there's not really that much going on in here right now, so don't even worry about checking everything out.
Yep. It's one for the crab, right? The claw.
Yeah.
No, I did it. I did everything already, I think. When I got the crab claw, I did it all. Remember? I don't think we have to worry about going underwater, actually. At all.
Okay, cool. Well, we still gotta get that scrap metal.
But that means... But, wait. I think I saw a squished flower, so I may have already collected
that. Did you already get it? You might have already got it. It kind of looks like you did. Okay, cool. Well, you got the soul, too. Now all we're going to do is climb up to the top right and get that gallery key. Did you do that already? I don't remember.
Top right. No, I don't think so. No, I didn't.
Okay, we're going to use the elephant to stomp on a block and get a key here.
Yeah, all right, cool.
It's not that far.
By the way, I'm not sure, of course.
Yeah, I don't remember.
I'm saying that, but I'm not sure.
Yeah, I don't remember, but I didn't remember you getting that soul either.
Oh, a block with the elephant?
Yeah.
Yeah, this one? Yeah, I think I did it already.
You did it already?
There you go.
Okay, well, then we can get the fuck out of here.
But I think there's something I haven't explored yet above, and that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go all the way above.
We're not going to mess with that yet.
No? Okay.
No, we can't really
do it. Because I think there's a room I haven't done anything in. Okay, so I can just
quit. There is. We're gonna
waste of time.
Yeah, definitely we're gonna be going in there, but right now not so much. Right now you can go ahead and go talk to Mimic
to give him the to give him the light shard. Yeah, that's right.
You bet. This thing's almost done. This dynamo should be pretty cool when it's finished. Right? Right?
Oh boy. I don't like the tone of that. For some reason.
Yeah.
Let me know if you come across that light shard. You found the light shard.
Found it, bitch.
That's for me, right? Yeah. It's for you, I guess. It attaches right next to the dark shard, right up. It's complete? Here. Wonderful. There's only one piece left, Uncle. Yep, okay. But we're almost at the end. Gosh, speaking of which, I need to split. Okay. Why do you keep saying that? Oh, haven't you heard about the end of the world? The Hypno Baron is summoning creature of unspeakable horror. I want to squeeze in as much fun as possible before the beast begins its world-ending rampage. Say what? Actually, I could use a lift. I'm going to ask Featherhead for a ride to the Hypno Baron's castle. Maybe I can get
they'll remember the Hypno Baron. So if anybody they'll remember the Hypno Baron.
The Hypno Baron's from there, yeah. Brandon, welcome to the stream. Maybe I can get a front row seat. Here's a map if you want to come. And we got Hypno Baron's castle map. That's our next destination.
Indeed.
Is that
the first time we've busted up his ship, you know, so...
Is that the moment where we actually get our hands on the Harpy transformation?
After we finish it, yeah.
Okay, cool. So that's exactly what we need to progress. So first we'll do the levels and we'll come back to those levels later.
That is. After we finish this, we're going to go back and... pretty much get everything.
Alright, cool. Sounds fair. So, yeah. let me get my hands on some upgrades real quick. There's a super attract, magic bracelet.
What's up, Brandon? Brandon!
Okay, mega shampoo. What's up?
Brandon! It is my man Brandon. I don't know, just having too much fun with that. It's my cat, everybody.
Hello, cat. I just got an upgrade. A few of them. We're gonna try to collect as much as possible. Sky, let me guess. You want a ride to Hypno Baron's castle? How did you know that hair weather friend of yours just tried to bum a ride? Oh, Roddy Tops. She'll lead you straight into trouble. But I have to stop the Hypno Baron. Typical. Don't say I didn't warn you. Are you ready for to lift off? Yes, let's go. Climb aboard. Let's go to Baron's Castle. Hypno Baron's Castle.
It is
and
dark.
We revealed another level.
It was.
Ooh. There's only two things to collect. Hello, cat, again. He really wants to talk. Sorry, I'm talking over you. I should stop.
No,
go ahead,
okay.
Go ahead and let us know you're okay, kitty. What's his name, by the way?
His name is Max.
Max the Cat.
Yeah. Max T Cat. The T stands for the.
T Cat.
His middle name is the. What's up, buddy? I'll give Daddy a kiss. That's right.
Oh my goodness. Max! Rip open the fabric of space-time and wash away humankind in a sea of eternal woe. Whoa.
Jesus.
Whoa. Or something along those lines. My brother told him how to summon the horror, and in exchange, we got a whole sack of sequin lens selected dark almonds roast.
That's horror. For those
you
in the
guys
chat.
Doomed humanity for a bag of coffee. I would do the same thing, actually. Doom humanity for a bag of coffee. It'd be awesome.
Yeah, depending on the time
of day.
Coffee. For sure.
Well, it was before 9 a.m., so... Alright. I'm going to find a way into Ipno Baron's summoning chamber and stop his plans before it happens. Coolio, I'll watch the fireworks from here. Alright. Best get the first row seat, then.
This place can be a little confusing.
Hello?
Floor layout. Mm-hmm. So...
Let's go. Okay, I see.
Definitely. You're going to want to take the... There's one thing in here. It's the heart container, and it's hidden kind of right behind you, actually, which is a little weird. So take the door all the way to the right.
Okay.
When you take the door to the right, it should take you into an area where there's some... You'll see two chains hanging from there. Take the chains down and then go all the way right.
I was checking the left side, actually.
I'm just going to save you the trouble here. Of
all right. Oh, come on. Kidding. Okay.
Yeah, you don't need to go there.
I don't know why I went to the slime girl.
Indeed. That was a backer enemy.
That was a backer enemy? Oh, wow.
Backer enemy.
Awesome,
there's
actually.
There's a spider girl that you see later on. It was also a backer enemy.
So where do you say that heart holder is? The same level as we come in?
No, it's right here. Go all the way across. Oh, no, wait, shit. No, right here. Or down. Go down and all the way across. I'm all confused.
Yeah, there's a ghost.
No, there's a bunch of mimics here. They don't trust any of these chests. They're all bullshit. By the way, that ghost is for those with decent eyes and somewhat of a knowledge of Nintendo. That is, what's her name from Swap Note? Nikki.
Oh, is it? Oh, so cool.
Yeah.
An awesome reference. She died.
She did die. Swap note died. Wait, where are you going? Go back to the door. Not that door.
That door here?
No, back to the other door. That you were just about to go inside.
Okay, I'm with Abner now.
Yeah. It was,
let's talk to him right away. And,
yeah. He wants a poster.
Like an awesome poster. Okay. Yeah. It's a brains no. On legs. Mm-hmm. Coffee brains. Coffee with brains in it. Not really. Then get lost. Ah, you're a butt. You're a butt. So, why do you want a poster? Me and Po are gonna take over this old castle. I'm concerned about this wall right there, right here. It's screaming for a poster. Some totally awesome black light poster. Mm-hmm. Okay, cool. Gonna fetch one. Boy, I'm confused. There's two chains here. Where should I go? I'm hanging on the chains right now.
Hanging on the stream is like delaying.
Catch on.
Go down and to the right. Down and to the right, and then all the way across to that door. And that should take you to the horror container.
All right. There's a door upstairs at the end of the corridor.
Yeah, go in the door.
Okay, I'll go in the door. Oh, there's a mimic here. I'm on the right side. But I'm gonna go for the left side, right? Nope.
No, you're...
I'm totally wrong, right?
Yeah, you're gonna go in that door later. Well, shit. No, yeah, this is later on. This is the wrong door.
Okay. I'm gonna go back because I wanna scavenge as much as possible. I think that was the exit, actually. That looked like the exit.
I
know where the exit is. Yeah. I know where the exit is, so that's a good thing.
Yeah, just fuck this place right now.
Heart holder.
No.
Is there anything else to keep in mind now? Like, collect anything else?
This is it around
here. The only thing I can, right? Okay.
Yeah, there's some stuff later on, but you need the harpy to get it.
So no need in the... I can just exit now, right? I'm safe to do it.
You can just exit, definitely. Let's get the fuck out of here.
That's not the right place to go.
No.
If my... if my map is correct, in my head...
No, go back through there, climb that chain, and then go to the door to the left. There you go, that's the one.
Yeah, I was actually aware of my mistake. But,
okay. The delay. Yeah,
that's what I was saying, I hope my map is correct.
Yeah, your map's correct, definitely.
Oh, would you like to save the game? Sure, of course. I try my best to have as little, delay as possible on streams, but I remember those blocks with the eye. That's awesome.
And believe it or not, there's actually no more stuff you can get in here right now.
So this okay, cool. That's nice to know.
Yeah, we're going to be pretty straightforward from here on out. And try to use that bat as much as possible too. You can cross a lot of gaps.
I should. I'm falling to my death like an idiot.
Favorite Shantae transformation? Like, well, there's favorite as far as the way it looks, or favorite as far as its usefulness.
The monkey form is my favorite.
Harpy's definitely, you know. The most useful. Yeah, the spider from this game is awesome. The monkey is absolutely might be the monkey just because it's so goddamn adorable. My all-time favorite though was during the making of the game. You know, there was a bunch of ideas for new transformations. And we had all these cool ones that just didn't make the game. We had a tiger cub and a pill bug, and we had a naga, and there was a succubus too. If anybody's seen these designs, they all look awesome. But that succubus, I love the design for that thing. I thought that was great. I really fought to get that into this game, but it sadly did not.
Yeah.
Which is kind of a shame. that spider girl there is a bone legs, and she is a backer enemy too. And there's like no way.
Oh, that's
to kill
that's
her.
That's the enemy you said that was also backed.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Tough as shit, man.
Yeah, they have that thing where they really defend themselves.
Yeah.
Well, that reminds me of Zelda 2, actually, that those enemies come in constantly. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
Oh my goodness.
I haven't played Zelda 2.
Zelda 2. Yeah.
God damn. 20 years or so. Like, it's been so long. Oops.
I haven't played Zelda 2 in a while, and I never finished the game, actually.
I don't think I ever did either. I never really found a reason to go back to it. It doesn't suck, like, I don't hate the damn game, but I just don't... It didn't speak to me. I guess a lot of people felt that way. So that was cool for what it was. You know what would be really cool is if they made... like a follow-up to Zelda 2. Like, if they did another Zelda in the style of Zelda 2, that would be kind of sweet.
I agree.
Just for the fuck
of it,
I think I
got the pattern for that. For that, spider monster.
Yeah.
Oh, look! You can buy new stuff. What do you want?
Indeed. Remember, to get 100%, we're going to have to buy all of Tuki's stuff, too.
So, Dryad Dance, I'm going to get it.
Yeah, definitely get everything you can right now from her.
That's all I can get. Unless I should trade, but... Oh, boy.
We don't need either of those until later. We never need the blobfish. The blobfish is like a joke transformation. We won't do anything.
I didn't know that. I thought it had something to do with like the blobfish character we found, but
nope, not at all. That gem jug, we're gonna use that though.
Fell down. I got a. Watch my step.
Wasn't there a game that had this? Something like this? Was it Yoshi's Island? The eye block thing? It was like Yoshi or maybe Donkey Kong Country. One of the Donkey Kong
those
Country.
Platforms, right? Yeah, I know. I think it was Donkey Kong Country. One of those games, actually.
Yeah. It was some great platformer, I think. Yoshi
and I hate those platforms. I can't get the timing right. There you
go. Yeah, it's a pain in the ass for sure.
You tell me.
Damn it, Jack.
You
it's
know
like
nothing.
You have a problem with concentration.
You have a problem with anything in general. Ha ha, you suck at everything. Oh, oh! Too close.
This old Shantae. It's as great as propane.
Oh boy, are we in the boss now? Did we just reach the boss? Here we go, Hypno Baron.
Yeah.
Chanting days are over, Mister. Ah, it's you. No matter. My incantation is already complete. Gasp! Tremble in fear as you witness the end of the world, of your world. No! Goodness, behold! The creature of unspeakable horror. No, no!
I guess.
Oh, goodness. Are you kidding me?
It's our old buddy!
Are you kidding me? That's the creature of...
He actually is. It's our buddy, the Squid Baron.
It's the guy.
Well,
it's the guy I've seen. This is the guy I've seen destroying the fourth wall the most in this series.
Fuck yeah, dude. That's what he does.
Perfect. Huh? Squid Baron. Check it. I've reached fifth boss status. There you go. That's one step away from top billing. I'd be surprised if they didn't name a game after me. Shantae versus the important Squid Baron. They'd call it. No, Squid Baron's Quest starring Shantae. There you go. Much better. In fact, just make it a Squid Baron game. Given, I'll even let you get in as a cheap DLC if you ask nicely. It can be a color palette swap. 99 cents sounds about right. You're out of your mind, Squid Baron. First of all, the titles always have a colon or, you know, the apostrophes in the name. Second, a Squid Baron spin-off game would only appeal to a subset of the same audience, so it's gonna sell like buns. How embarrassing. And third, swapping my color palette for yours would make me red and purple, which you already... you already are. Oh my goodness. How dare you? Let's do this up all crazy style. Shoot a funky boss track and come at me. Oh yeah, funky indeed. Creature of unspeakable horror.
Squid Baron is awesome.
He is a horror. Oh, the timing of that spike ball was completely off. Just
what's up, Censored Bleeps?
Hey, Censored Bleeps, welcome to the stream.
What's the word? Yeah, we got this Shantae happening in here. This delightful
Squid
We're
Squid
fighting
Baron
the Squid
awesome.
Baron right now. If you remember our old buddy, the Squid Baron. Generally,
he has been destroyed.
Generally known for being a dickhead, breaking the fourth wall, and being
okay.
a dickhead.
Now it's the boss fight. Duo Barons. Dastardly duo.
Yeah, this is kind of the real boss fight.
Okay, cool. Makes sense.
I always take out Squid Baron first, but you can take him out in either order. So. HGH Squid Baron. You mean the one that we're fighting right now?
Yeah, we are. It's happening. He's the final boss.
This is a moment in Shantae history. It's a landmark moment. It's the first time any two barons have teamed up for a boss battle. We got the Hypno Baron and the Squid Baron.
He has some health.
So you're going to definitely want to heal yourself here. These boys are...
Oh, yeah, that's right. I almost forgot.
These boys mean business.
Yeah, it's the fifth boss after all, right?
Indeed, yeah.
Dude. Thank you. Now, explosions, and now we have one Baron left.
Fuck yeah.
He's the type of Baron that just flies around. I hate those flying bosses.
Yeah. Hypno Baron didn't really think about an attack strategy, so he's just
Let's
sort
do
of
a generic
around.
Flying enemy.
But then again,
he
didn't
wasn't
really
prepared.
Know what was going to happen today, so.
I mean, he's invoking the creature that supposedly is going to end the world, and Squid Baron pops up.
Exactly.
It's like the opposite.
I mean, well, I don't know. You know,
I think I blew him for good.
He hasn't been around since Risky's Revenge. I mean, it's okay, Hypno Baron. Give you some slack here, buddy.
merchandising rights? Say what? Squid Baron hats and mugs and t-shirts. Oh, goodness. Oh, I see what you mean by ending the world.
Yeah.
Who told you that?
Turns out, it was all myth for it.
Oh,
they're talking
okay.
about Squid Baron's merchandising rights.
That was okay. Sorry for
we'll fund evil for eternity.
Sorry, Hypno Baron, for you know, messing around with your. You've been a good person. Hello, Adam. Welcome to the stream. Hey, hey.
Yeah. So basically, what happened right here just now was Hypno Baron and Squid Baron were sitting around talking about Squid Baron's merchandise and how they were going to make merchandise of the Squid Baron, and then Shantae busted in and whooped both of their asses for seemingly no reason.
Harpy dance. Oh my goodness, he flies exactly the same way as the GBA version.
Yeah,
the GBC version, sorry. Ah, that's why I don't like the Harpy, because it's so it's so not precise.
Yeah.
It's a good thing, though. It balances out the fact that you can fly anywhere, but, congratulations. You've thwarted evil 5 times in a single day. Not really. That's gotta be a new personal best. Being a genie that's only half hero sure isn't easy. It's the other way around, Bolo. I know what you meant, and thanks. But now, I really owe it to Uncle to get that final component. So what is it anyway, Uncle? According to this, oh dear. The blueprint shows a hand crank mechanism. Okay. Groan.
I was gonna make a hand crank joke. We've got to go back to Main Street. That's what we're doing right now.
Okay. But a zombie hamster. Okay, cool. Brilliant. Settled then. Oh, a zombie hamster. You see this machine taking, like, shape? It's turning into a monster itself. Don't tell me it's the actual final boss.
Oh, it is.
We are actually... What?
It's certainly turning into a monster.
You.
It's pretty cool looking, though, right?
Are you kidding me now? We are actually going to battle this thing?
I cannot confirm nor deny.
Oh, goodness. All right.
It's interesting, though. It's definitely interesting.
Oh boy, yeah, alright.
All I can say about that is, remember Wario Land 3?
Mm-hmm.
What did that game have you doing?
Oh, you mean in story-wise?
Yeah, kinda had you going around collecting stuff.
Oh, hi, kid. I just saw the Azure Knight over at the item shop. Okay, thank you. That's actually really important for me to know, because I'm gonna go there. Hello, hi, I am the Azure Knight. You! Were you sent forth by the Crimson Knight to retrieve his regal headwear? I would not yield it to a knave such as yon. Okay. Oh, goodness, I won't read anymore. Out loud, at least. Oh, fine, Vorpal Blade. Okay, cool.
Indeed. And that Vorpal Blade is hidden underwater in Main Street. Pretty easy to find.
Okay, cool. Let's get there. Indeed. Shall we?
Indeed.
This guy's archery. Archery, what? Let's go. Main Street. Main Street, the burning town.
Yeah. Which is still on fire.
Which is still on fire. Goodness, will I ever put out the fire?
Shantae is on her fifth adventure today. And the town is still on fire.
Oh, goodness. Let's go.
I forget which water it was. I think it's the one right before the end of the level. I almost said episode.
Episode.
Near the end of the episode.
I don't know what I have yet to collect here. Got this.
Here, we've
pretty much cleaned the house, right?
We've got everything. As soon as we get this Vorpal Blade here, we're going to go to the next part of the level of the episode.
Of the episode, and then, yeah.
And we're going to get the Waterfall Relic, which basically lets us ride waterfalls.
Oh, cool. Okay, can't wait for that. That's going to be useful for unlocking some things later on. Mermaid Falls.
Yeah, that's that one gate in Mermaid Falls. That's what that's for. Oh, we've got a piece of scrap metal, too, at the very end of the level. And that's pretty much it. This place should be, by my calculations, finished after this.
I like to kill all the enemies. I don't know why. Let's just,
it just feels good.
Visit here. I think this is done.
It just feels good. Something about whacking motherfuckers in the head with your hair.
And it's quick now because we have the hair fully upgraded.
Indeed.
Now, fast hair whipping, that's different. I like it a lot. But... oh, come on. Thank you.
They definitely want the fast hair. Here we go. I think he's in here, but we need the mermaid.
Yep. That's true. Hello, sir. I'm the mermaid. I just came for you. Hey, girl. I'm the adventure man. You're an adventurer like me. You like games. I got a game. Here it goes. Okay, guess what? Monkey butt! Nah, that was lame. Listen, since you made it all the way here, tell you what. I'm giving you this Vorpal Blade. I swiped it from Zer. Okay. Cool. Got the Vorpal Blade.
Be right back.
All right. Got the Vorpal Blade that we can move on now. And apparently we still have scrap metal, so let's go. Let's go out. Wiggle that tail.
Okay, cool.
Awesome.
That's all we need right in here, so go to the next part of the level, and at the very beginning of the next area, and I mean right at the very beginning, turn into the harpy and just fly straight up.
Okay, we'll do that. Isn't there a scrap metal to collect?
You should find something pretty cool. No, it's the scrap metal is like near the way end of the stage.
Oh, okay, I see.
Yeah, dude, Luigi, man. Supposedly that adventure dude is super hardcore, but I don't fucking believe him. I don't think Shantae is buying his shit either, dude.
The waterfall. Oops, not the spider. As much as I like the spider form, And we're not using it. I can fly over all of this, right? There's nothing to collect specifically. I don't think. That hurts. Oh, that will hurt. Okay, that hurts. Nope, it's back there.
It's gonna be pretty much at the very end. You're gonna have to break some blocks with the elephant.
Oh, yeah, yeah, you're right. I remember seeing the flower. That's why I was trying to look for the flower. I forgot the fact that you actually have to break some blocks to reveal it. There you go, it's here. Yeah. Okay. Scrap metal. 4 of 5. Area done?
Cool. That should be it for Main Street.
Cool. Awesome. Let's get out then.
Yeah, let's give this shit to the other asshole in the item shop. And he should
give call us him some, names.
Something kind of cool.
He's gonna give us something nice. Don't call him names. He's cool.
He's a shit.
Look, he's here. Yeah, it got it.
Great for us.
Noble and brave, thank you. Regal headwear. Oh, Foxy Grandma. Foxy Grandma hat! Foxy. Where is Foxy Grandma?
Foxy Grandma is to the right, over by
oh,
the gallery.
Oh, hey, Arnie Melon. Just Grandma Blobfish, same as before. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Need to find a new hat. Okay. I'm here. Take the hat. Is that what folks wear these days? Okay. Hey, goes well with your mouth, I guess. Words to leave by. I really like this soundtrack. It's awesome.
It is pretty great.
I said that like 3 times already, or 4. Mermaid bubble! That's exactly what we needed.
That's definitely good, especially since we're going back to Mermaid Fall.
Exactly. I'm trying to remember what else we need the bubble and the... Well, yeah, the bubble for. But I think Box there's one thing... wait.
There's a thing
forget, it's not right.
Too.
So, where should we go?
Mermaid Falls.
Alright. Recommended to go to Mermaid Falls. We're going to check the map before we go there, just to make sure that we have everything if everything is correct. So, as far as we can see, Squirrel Town Square is complete. Main Street is complete too. Mermaid Falls is just one thing left, 2 sunken souls and a heart holder missing.
Mm-hmm.
We have 1 heart holder and a sunken soul missing in Tasseltown. That's all.
Yep.
Oh, Cape Crustacean. There's a lot of things to collect. And Hypno Baron has 1 thing left. All right, so let's go to Mermaid Falls. Would you like
you
to
got
save the game? Yes.
You can get all that stuff underwater now. And if you go all the way to the right underwater, you'll find a little area that you can access with the bubbles. And
okay.
go in there and there's a heart container in there. So that's where
cool.
that is.
Cool. Awesome. I was going to explore down there, so...
yeah, you
were. Oops. First, I want to transform into mermaid and try to go down here and see if I can, if I missed something. Going around just in case. Here's a bubble, by the way.
And since you've got the waterfall relic, now you can ride up waterfalls. So there's...
There's also that. Yeah, that's true. And we're going to have to check that out, too, here. Because yeah. I believe that the thing with the portal we saw when we were playing as the mouse had... yeah, there you go. That's the part you were talking about.
Bingo.
And there you go. Waterfall. Awesome. Just press up. That's cool. Heart holder. And technically, I think we are only missing one heart holder, right?
Should be, yeah.
Because we always follow the rules of alignment of hearts. If there's one heart missing to make them equal, it's because you missed something.
Indeed.
Can I use this waterfall? I guess not. Not all the waterfalls can be used, right?
Yeah, not all of them.
Okay, cool. The bubble only works underwater. That's also nice to know.
Yeah. Mermaid's pretty much powerless out of the water.
Yeah, I noticed that.
Such a cutie patootie.
Here we go. This is the waterfall we want to ride on.
That's the one.
And I think you can use the crab instead of a mermaid, just in case.
You can use the crab. But I would just suggest to get in the habit of using the mermaid. Just because fuck
I
the
thought
crab.
So too.
Fuck the fucking
talent.
Crab.
Just to check the harpy talon. It's a projectile. I remember when you scratch the heck out of enemies.
That's pretty much it for this area. And there's
really?
Only one thing that's it. There's only one thing for us to get in the next area too, and I think you know where to go.
Oh, in the next area. Oh, crap. I mistakenly called. Okay, no problem. We go back to the level. Dang it. Instead of dancing there, I actually called Wrench.
Jesus.
You dummy. Oh. Warp dance. Chakalaka. Magikarps. Wait, Harpy. Transform! It's all the way to the top, right?
It does look like a feather. And yeah, it's all the way to the top. It's got two torches outside of the door. It's going to be sort of a little test of all our transformation. Not all of them, but a good handful.
All right, don't spoil it. I'm going there right away. And I'm going to try to see if I can figure that puzzle out. Which should be easy enough, right?
You should be fine.
There you go. I remember this room we didn't go in. Oops, that was the wrong one already. I can use the harpy. Yeah, why not? Awesome. Yeah, the spider foam is actually useful.
Indeed. This is one of probably four or five areas that you actually use it.
Okay, here we go. We got the... what? Data chip. Okay, that's... cool.
Yeah.
I guess.
And that's it for Mermaid Falls. Congratulations.
Yay! Oops. We can call Wrench this time.
Yep, time to head on down to old Tasseltown.
The harpy towel and the projectiles are feathers, yes. I kinda noticed that too. Oh, I missed a sunken soul.
Did you?
In Mermaid Falls. Yeah.
Was it the one I was telling you to go get? I think it was.
I got one from the first area. Is there one in the second area?
There is.
You can only get with the bubbles.
Well, there's two in the first area. There's the one you got with using the crab claw, and then there's one where you break some blocks.
I'm talking about the bubble ability only. Is there
right.
One in the second area that you need the bubble to reach?
There is, yeah.
Okay, so I'm gonna go there. That's what I missed.
Yeah. Oh, you got
it.
I wasn't sure if
it was missed here or if it was in the next area, but I'm gonna go to the next area then. And because I know we couldn't get some of the sunken souls because we didn't have the bubble.
You know what? That's right. That's what I was thinking. When we were in here before, I was like, oh, go and get that one, because I forgot that you didn't have the bubble. So now you can go get it.
Yep. So let's go do this. Oh, boy. I gotta figure out where it is. Okay, it's not here. Just... because let's get some gems. You know how I am with the money.
Oh, I do.
Get the money. Oh, come on, you idiot. It's not here.
I have never seen this man tip above 12% in a restaurant.
Goodness.
In my life.
Never. That would be a mistake of my part. And
indeed.
I don't do mistakes. Saw my thing. Okay, forget it. It's in the next section. Let's move.
Yeah, it's
checking
the same
all the water things.
Yeah, it's the same area you found that that scrap metal in. It should be like right there.
Oh, okay. There you go. I found it. And now it's done. Now it's done. It's finished.
It has been done.
Yeah, Leonard, this stream is actually playing on 1080p, so if you're on a computer or watching on TV, you actually have a better, even better, note of little details that are in the game, which are awesome. There's so many little details. It's really cool. What's our next stop, then? We go to Tasseltown and try to get the remainder of the sunken souls and
yeah, we're going to Tasseltown.
Yeah, I think it's the best move too.
I'd say we just blast through this shit in order.
Definitely. Ready to go. Transform! I love how you get so many gems in this in this area, in this level.
Oh yeah, it's a definitely a great place for that.
Get underwater with our lady.
Yeah.
Should be a blocker segment.
Right where you find the sunken soul, you're also going to find an iron slab.
Oh, okay. Yeah. In the tunnel.
Yeah. You got it.
Iron slab, which, yeah, here you go.
Oh, yeah, tassel awesome. Sound. Isn't this place so nice now that Holly is dead?
It's actually the best.
Man, it just feels really great. Holly
is dead.
It was
a pain in my life.
Well, actually, if you want to get technical, the real Holly died hundreds of years ago.
Yeah, well, as long as the memory still remains, I do believe that she is still a nuisance. She still exists in some form of existence.
We'll see.
It's a crab area, right? Yeah. So I guess I already did this. Yeah, I did this already.
Well, that's it.
Yeah. No, there's still a heart holder, actually, in this level. I wanted to get that heart holder. And I believe it might be...
There's a heart holder in here? It might...
Yeah, I haven't got that heart holder yet.
Is it in the tower?
Did we miss something in the tower? That would be bad. Oh goodness, one of the puzzles for the mouse, maybe?
I don't think it's out here. I think it's in the tower.
Yeah.
I thought we
just
got
let me just go on my way there. I'm not gonna transport, just make sure that I haven't missed anything.
Yeah. Let me
see the flower here.
Some Cause there's nothing
gems.
Left out here. I mean, we got everything out here.
That's weird. Tasseltown's music is really good.
Tasseltown.
I mean, the game has awesome music. Hey, it looks awesome too. The graphics in this game are so, like, great.
There's not a bad piece of music in the whole game. And the graphics are just as great, you're right.
Guys, you definitely should pick up this game. I'm not kidding now. It's like, if you don't play this at least once in your life, you don't know what's good.
If you don't play Shantae Half-Genie Hero, you are a stupid doo-doo head.
A stupid doo-doo. And I'm gonna tell your mommy.
I will. I will fucking find each and every one of you, and I will call your respective mothers, and I will tell them what you've been doing on the internet.
Watching people play and not playing, it's a crime.
Well, oh, my son, he would rather watch other people play and not play the game himself. I don't know what's
then,
wrong.
Buy the game and don't play it. At least support the ones who did it.
Fuck yeah.
Is that an area for a...
A bit like Sephiroth. It is kind of like Sephiroth, isn't it? I didn't even think about that. It is. Holly Lingerbean and Sephiroth are kindred spirits. Mm-hmm. They're both sons of bitches, too. Figures. I guess the only way to have a consciousness that lives after you die is to be a son of a bitch. So
that always works, actually.
Yeah.
So because the consciousness haunts everybody.
Oh, yeah, dude. I better get ready. I'm going to have the sweetest consciousness that's still around.
Oh my goodness. I'm too nice for that. I'm gonna be forgotten really quickly.
Indeed. I'll see you all in hell. Just kidding. I won't be there because my consciousness will be here.
Ha ha! Goodness. It's like, ha ha, tricked you.
Bay? Bay? Bay's right here. Bay is wearing his red pants right here. Okay, that's Bay. I don't want to hear about your stupid memory vampire girlfriend. Okay? She is dead. And so is her worm.
The worm.
They had a great boss. Oh, to Adam, you're going back to juvie, my friend. I'm sorry. Unless you go and pick up a copy of Shantae, Half-Genie Hero, available now.
In a store near you. Grab now a copy of Shantae, Half-Genie Hero for a price of $29.99. No, it's too extra. Actually, it's too expensive. It's actually I'm not lying. It's actually, I was right. $29.99, right? Something like that.
I bought it for $29.
Yeah. That's right.
Might have went down. Right. $30, man. That's a really good fucking game. Yeah.
For this kind of game, it's nothing.
I bought it 3 times.
And that's the puzzle. Remember this puzzle?
Yeah.
I don't know. I feel like I did everything. I don't know. I don't remember where it is.
You did this, so we don't need to be in here.
Where's that heart holder? There's a heart holder.
It's gotta be in here.
Watch me getting out of the level and checking out the stats of this level, and no heart holder will be needed to be fine. Waste of time. Oh, there you go. Forgot about this mouse hole. Mouse hole.
Okay.
We forgot about this, yeah, last time.
Okay, good.
So, there was...
There's your heart holder.
Oh my goodness, this is an actual maze.
We're finally maxed out,
dude. I'm all powerful now.
You are. Let's go to Cape Coast Station.
Heart holder. There you go. And we can fly off of here. Full health. Awesome. Perfect hearts everywhere. Oh boy. Oh boy, wait. Game froze for a second.
Oh shit.
Awesome. Alright, cool. We're back. This here needs a key and 2 items that we don't know. Cape Crustacean, here we go. Always say it funny.
On your marks. Get set. Go!
Go!
Indeed. And you can use your warp dance to
skip the race.
And I think, well, actually, I know you can skip the next segment too. Everything you want is going to be inside Ammo Baron's ship. So.
If you say so.
Sk- Skeleton Grunty is the best bae. I don't know, Louis. Yeah, she's pretty rad, but I'm not sure if she's sort of rad in that way.
Visually rad.
Get a resurrection. Good luck resurrecting somebody who, some chick who died, what'd she say, centuries ago? I don't know. Unless that bitch is a mummy somewhere. You know what I'm saying?
It's gonna be nothing left but bones. Calcified bones. That was spider thing. Yeah. Oh no. Actually, I did this already.
Did you do that?
No,
I didn't do this.
I did this actually with the spider. Yes.
Okay,
yeah,
cool.
It's open.
You did?
Yeah.
You got the
remember the spider? Okay. Spider is
sweet.
Awesome. Sweet, dude.
Usually wait till I get the harpy to do this. Awesome.
Oh no, I'm far ahead of you. Far ahead. New strats, boy.
Well, let's not go that far here. So right now we're going to go over to the fuel room and have Mermaid Shantae swim around in some jet fuel. It should be right in here, actually. Go through the floor to the right.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh boy, I died. Lasered. Because of the harpy. I should stop harping around. Oh boy, I should stop jumping around too like a moron. I don't think the bubble is going to do anything. But anyway, I'm going to turn it on.
All you need is the waterfall red, which you have. Da, 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 da.
Last metal scrap is here?
No.
Yeah, I got
quite.
It. Yeah, I got it. I'm not questioning. I'm telling you. I got the last scrap metal.
Oh, there's that. I thought you meant over in the...
Yeah, oh yeah, okay.
The fuel room, yeah. Yeah,
okay,
the scrap metal is right there. And here there's a gallery key.
That's completely useless. Okay, cool.
In this case, first take the first waterfall, and then when you get up there, take the last waterfall. Makes it pretty simple. First and last.
Got the chest.
That's a good choice, Luigi. Classic Daisy is much better than modern Daisy. I'm gonna go on the record and say that. But Shantae is the best bae of all.
Boy, oh boy, we still have two items to collect, right?
In here? No, we've actually only got one, and it's going to be interesting. We're going to get the spider venom, and we're actually not supposed to get it right now, because we don't have the bat sonar, but we're going to get it anyway. There's a way
to do
it.
Do you
want
to challenge me?
It's kind of challenging. You just basically you're going to be in an all black room, and you're going to need to know where to land with the harp. So there's like spikes everywhere.
It's through here, right?
Yeah, just keep going until you find that area with the little groove in the side that you go into with the monkey. And it's right through there. Now, you're supposed to have the bat sonar, which would create this little kind of ring of light around you so you could see in there. But we're not going to have that. So basically,
oh boy,
what we're going to do is we're going to go straight up with the harpy. All the way up. We're going to fly all the way over to the rock and land. And we got to be very careful because there's literally spikes fucking everywhere.
Okay. So you mean harpy, right? And then go all the way up?
Indeed. All the way up, the way over to the right.
Okay, I'm moving to the left, to the right, yeah.
And you can land anywhere.
Oh boy. Okay, here we go.
I'm going to work the stream to catch up here.
Yeah. Boy.
Okay, now turn back into Shantae. But don't do anything. There's spikes everywhere.
Yeah, I'm landing on that platform.
Okay, turn back into Shantae.
Yeah, that's done. Now I just fall on the right side?
Yes.
Okay, and now I'm on a platform. I move a little bit to the left. Or transform into a bat.
You're going to want to go... You want to get to the bottom and then go to the right.
Yeah. Okay.
Cool.
To the right?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm against the wall. Okay.
Drop
one.
Drop again. We're not on the bottom.
Oh, I saw it. Thanks to the explosion of the Okay. Thank you. Spider venom.
You got it.
What now?
See, what we did now is we just effectively made the bat sonar completely useless. But let's go get it anyway. Let's go.
Yeah, we are going to get it.
For sure.
That's the show. I can quit the level, right? No problem.
Yeah, we got everything.
Okay, cool. Because the thing is, you don't see your progression in the level. You have to exit the level for you to know what you did.
And indeed.
That sometimes can be problematic. And I'm guessing the sonar is in the castle, right?
It is. It's not going to be as tricky this time. We're just going to fly up through the roof.
Mm-hmm. I noticed there's a hole on the roof.
Exactly. We're going to go up there. There's going to be two things, actually, though. We're going to go to the left and get the sonar, but if we go to the right, we will find Poe, Abner, and Roddy Tops' brother, and he will actually give us the zombie hamster that Mimic needs to finish the dynamo. And awesome. We already got the iron slab, so we're good. We're doing good.
Here we are. I got the Wi-Fi. The Wi-Fi signal.
You indeed. Which is completely useless because the only would use it in is that area in Cape Crustacean, which we just totally fucked up.
That was a waste of ability, actually. It reminds me of the spiders. The mouse bite, actually.
Yeah, well, at least the mouse bite actually works now.
By the way, guys, this is a spider venom.
Spider venom's cool as shit.
Oh, but the hitbox on those guys. Oh, my goodness. Just playing around with the spider form. It's so cool.
That motherfucking spider form is cool as shit, boy. I don't even give a fuck.
Indeed it is.
Don't give a fuck.
Okay, here you go. Poe, talk to me.
What's up, Poe? You fucking
long time no see.
Fucking guy, you.
I have a question. Did they update the controls too? Because now I feel like I can. I don't know if you could do that before, but you can talk to people with B. With B, no, with the X, with the attack button. Which I don't think you could before.
You know, it's. I'm not sure about the Steam version.
Interesting.
You could do that on the Wii U version, but I couldn't really tell you about things that they're tweaking on Steam. It's very possible. It's getting updated constantly.
How about that poster that Abner wanted?
We're not going to do that until a little later.
All right. We're done here?
We're done here. Now.
All right.
It's time. What we're going to do now is we're going to go to the gallery and talk to the mayor. Go ahead and open up all those doors.
Yep, that's what we're going to do. Now we have all the keys, we are going to get a new little thing from the mayor, which I don't know what it is, but I know it's useful, so let's get to it.
It's cool.
And we had two keys missing, if you remember correctly, from the last stream, and now we are going to open those two doors. And I don't know if you should take the time to watch the gallery for a second and see what's inside.
There's some neat stuff. It's a mixed bag, you know, some really good pieces, some totally shitty pieces. As expected.
Okay, well, I guess fan art time is now. We opened all the doors, we are going to talk to the mayor real quick, and we are going to check out concept arts and fan arts. Magical tiara. What does the magical tiara do? What does it do? Magical, a fountain of magic. Okay, cool. I'm not sure.
The magical tiara.
Wait a minute. Bonus art is question marked. Sorry.
The magical tiara basically makes it to where you've got unlimited magic. Like, it never goes down, it never depletes.
Oh, okay, that's really useful.
Yeah, it's pretty much the coolest thing ever. You can look at some fan art, and whenever you're ready, you can go ahead and go.
Definitely. I was asking why those first few arts were have the big question mark. Is that to not spoil me or something? Because
no, those
spoilers.
Those are the ending screens that you get for beating the game under certain conditions. So
okay, cool. Okay, I see. I'm just passing through, just checking them out for people to have. I'm not going to spend too much time on them, but as you can see, we have the concept arts for most of the. This is a race level, Cape Crustacean chests, the ending pad. See a lot of cool things. It's awesome. I like those galleries. Really going quickly, concept art for Shantae, like sketches.
It's pretty so cool. Cute.
Or risky too, that's awesome. Maybe we're gonna... Those are the concept arts for the... Not the concept arts, but the drawings for the... Oh, there you go, the costumes. For Roddy Tops, and the ones for the, yeah, awesome. I like the ponytail with the bikini one in this picture of Shantae with the blue coat, the blue little coat, yeah, and the striped bikini. Looks really cute. First level, Castle Town, and the other beginning too. Yeah, that's all the beginning. Some cool images. How the level are laid out. Oh, look. Yeah, the factory. Skull Town at night. It's crazy. I love this. Here's the gooey girl, slime girl. Mmm, awesome. Oh, this, designs for Shantae. I love them. Yeah. The counterfeit mermaids. That enemy comes up in the game at some point? No, I don't think so. But it was in the first Shantae, at least. I remember. Poop toot.
Yeah, that never shows up.
The worm. The part that I died a lot. The mermaid. Okay, cool. That's awesome. There's the Baron. And now we move to fan art.
Yay. We're all excited to see that stuff, right, fellas?
I am actually excited to see that because this picture is adorable.
There's a couple winners in here, I think.
The toast one.
Yeah. Well, that's a classic, definitely. I've always been a fan of that picture. I was really excited to actually see it show up in this game, so there's a few of them actually that I'm pretty familiar with that showed up in here. Which is cool. I'm definitely glad about it. Some of them, you know, she looks like a man right there.
Yeah, there are some pictures that she, it's cool. Yeah. See, that it's really, at the end of the day, it's a really big thank you for the fans who made the artworks. And supported the project, and like I do for my gallery, I accept pretty much anyone who does something because they took their time to do anything specifically. And I think it's awesome. Even though they're not all good, some of them are really, really fantastic.
Well, yeah, I mean, like, what are you supposed to do? You know, it's like, oh, I'm sorry, this is too crappy.
Yeah, it's too bad because the person took their time, even though it might not be professional and all that. Well, they tried, right? And they did something.
Sir, goodness. Sir, we regret to inform you that your art is simply too crappy. This art is crappy as fuck. It's a piece of shit. And keep your day job, you stupid motherfucker.
Sincerely, we all go through learning, right? We all end up learning how to draw at some point. We have to practice somehow, so why not creating fan art of our favorite characters?
True. There's the succubus I was talking about. Yep. She actually had a lot of fan art. Which is pretty cool, considering she didn't even make it in the game. I'm really hoping that she does, especially since she does actually have, you know, fan art in this game. We're holding out for a succubus. The ninja costume, that's coming soon too. That's going to be DLC. She's going to have these alternate costumes that change your stats. One of the, that bikini one with the little coat, that's another one of them. So there's a Mighty Switch Force one too. Not sure when these are happening, if it's going to be before or after Risky comes out.
Well, that's all for the gallery. I hope you guys weren't bored watching the gallery, but I really like to watch those things, and I'm probably going to get back and watch them one by one calmly, but at least it's on video, so you guys had the chance to see that. Now we're going to the bathhouse, waiting for people who actually left while I was doing that. and we're fully recovered. And now we are going to talk to Mr. Mimic.
Indeed. And we're going to go fire up that dynamo. It's done.
When you've got both his zombie hams... Oh, okay. But I got them. Found both of them. Iron slab and hammer. And hammer. Oh my goodness. Yes, an MC Hammer.
Shantae is kind of wearing MC hammer pants. Huh. She got hammer pants on, dude.
Yeah.
An alternate costume. I want to see an MC Hammer alternate costume for her.
That'd be awesome. Did I miss anything? Nope, we are just in time. Gather around, everyone. Fire up this thing. Yes. Oh, it's time. We're ready, Uncle. Mm-hmm. I hope it explodes. Oh, it will, all right. Our faces.
Some heavy shit's about to happen.
Oh, goodness, it moves. Oh, goodness, it moves. Yeah, not bad. Oh, crap, of course.
Yeah.
Ah, I don't like the looks of that. Take the hamster off. Take the hamster off. Too dangerous. Look out. No! Oh, of course. The laser touches Shantae. She's trapped. Oh, goodness. What will we do? Okay.
What the fuck?
Oh, goodness. Look at it. Oh, my goodness.
It's pure unspeakable evil incarnate.
It's Miss Pirate is back. Risky Boots.
Well, I was talking more about Nega Shantae, but...
Oh, no. Are you kidding? It's time. You swapped the blueprints. That's right. You evil... I knew it since the beginning of the game. You were up to something. And you told us that. You knew she'd come back.
That explains why she was so cool about getting beat so easily in the beginning of the game. Shantae even remarks on that. If you recall.
Dark magic. No!
Uh-oh.
Hello, Nega Shantae. Oh, boy.
We haven't seen you since the end of Risky's Revenge. How's it going? Are you still pissed off?
Oh, my goodness. You monster, let her go. I have no intentions of keeping her. Durance has served her purpose. Oh no, major skill, dark magic, that's not good. But why stop there? Okay, Oh, that's bad. Okay, You come back here this instant. No, impossible. Oh boy. That's such bad news. Okay, I knew this machine was going to be troubles since the beginning. Yeah. I knew it was bad luck, but I didn't know it was going to be this extent of bad luck.
We're not even done with that fucking machine either.
I want to destroy bit by bit.
It's still got some more. You know what? It's not even an electricity machine. It's a bullshit machine. If they ever ask you, what does the dynamo do? It's like, oh, it causes bullshit to happen. You just turn it on and fucking bullshit happens.
My goodness.
Nega Shantae. For anyone who doesn't know, Nega Shantae, 100% pure, unfiltered evil. She's the final boss of Risky's Revenge. Of course, right here, what we're dealing with is a sort of Shantae and Nega Shantae are sort of battling mentally for control over, you know, her psyche.
Here we go. I think it's what you just said now. Darkness spreading, my strength increasing, and you. Don't
you're
do this!
You're much too weak.
Exactly, you're much too weak. How does it feel to lose? To have failed your friends and family so miserably? Please, everyone's still counting on me. No. This is how it ends. Here, in the darkness. When no one can save you. No!
You never stood a chance.
You never stood a chance. Goodbye. Stop. Here's the friends calling for her. How did you get here? How pathetic. Shantae, listen. It's me, Sky. We've been best friends for as long as I can remember. I know you're confused right now, and that the dark magic has you surrounded. But you've got to fight it. Remember who you really are. Find your loyalty and honesty. Break free of the darkness and follow your heart. One heart. Boom. So beautiful. Okay, next. Shantae, I know I can be a rotten friend, and I messed up a lot, but I want you to know that I've always believed in you. You're a friend to everyone, even to someone like me who everyone else is afraid of. Remember who you really are. Find your kindness and compassion. Break free of the darkness and follow your heart. Is this actually going to work? Hey, it's my boy Bolo. The best character ever. Shantae, there you are. Look, I know you are just acting weird because of the dark magic inside you, but your uncle is really worried. We're all worried. I know you'd never give up on us, so we won't give up on you. Remember who you really are. Find your strength and courage. And now wake up. Wake up and fight. Oh boy.
Bitch is evil. Evil motherfucking genie up in here.
And apparently she's being converted.
But luckily, the love that Shantae has for her friends and family is far greater than the evil of Nega Shantae.
You know, this would actually be a perfect cue to play as Shantae's friends if she would just went on a rampage and we had to stop Shantae for a few moments in the level. That would be awesome, cool, right?
Maybe that'll be the other gameplay mode.
Where am I?
You just gotta go after Nega Shantae.
Yeah, because that was kind of underwhelming for the appearance of Nega Shantae. I expected to see more of that, more mischievous.
Well, you know,
I think this part of the story was just inserted because it had to happen because of the machine, and I wish there was a little bit more to it. It was nice, though, but, you know, still needed a little bit more on that aspect. Give her a moment.
You know, originally, the idea was, this really wasn't supposed to be like this. Originally, the idea was, and you can see it on their Kickstarter page, was there was going to be a whole chapter about Nega Shantae.
It wasn't backed.
It didn't get funded. So they added this part in anyway, which was pretty awesome to see, because I think we all kind of thought that Nega Shantae wasn't going to make it in at all. So it was pretty cool to see. But yeah, it should have been a lot more.
Just to let people know that they actually considered that, and they made Nega Shantae for the game, but didn't actually got the support necessary for it to happen. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a shame. It's a shame.
Yeah.
It's a real shame.
We'll see. We'll see what the future holds.
Risky's hat. Risky, you just let the hideout, like, you dropped the hideout map on the floor. Are you kidding me now? Risky did everything right. She left the hideout map on the floor.
Well, that's not going to be Christ. The biggest mistake.
Yeah.
We're going to need to find some clues here, but it's going to be pretty easy to find these clues because they're all going to be held by our buddies.
Okay, cool.
Four of our old friends. Can you think of four friends that we have that we've met over the years?
Four friends.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. I can't think of it right now. Clues. Over the games? Over the past few games?
Yeah. Well, you'll notice. You'll know as soon as you get outside.
Okay. I kind of want to guess before going outside. Oh no, I don't remember at all. Let me see. I give up. Oh, okay. Hello, Techno Baron. Okay, you're talking about the Barons. Okay.
Yeah. The Barons.
Okay.
All
okay.
Have
I thought it was an extra character that I forgot about, an extra four characters that I forgot about. But no. There you go. There are here. The Barons will help us.
Yeah, they've all got a thing for you. We actually went and got their stuff. The data chip is for Techno Baron. And he's been assigned 1 billion hours of community service.
Oh, I found the data chip, so you can give me the info. Here we go. Risk his cufflink. Awesome. Leave me, of course. You gave me what I wanted. Hello, Ammo Baron. What are you doing here? Spare parts. Oh, you need spare parts? Scrap metal.
Like some
okay,
scrap metal?
I actually got those. Right here in my pocket. I don't know why I collect scrap metal, but here we go. I got those. Little secret. Risky's pendant. I wonder who has Risky's top part.
Well, there's certainly going to be a guy in the bathhouse.
Yeah, I wonder that's what I thought. Hello, Hypno Baron. What are you doing here? Oh, taking a bath, relaxing after invoking this merchandise negotiations.
It's funny to think that out of all the Barons, Hypno Baron is the one that's going to be chilling in the bathhouse.
Yeah.
Talk about
evil. Oh, the Sunken Souls. You need 10 of them? Oh, that's quite a coincidence. Actually, I don't know why I collect Sunken Souls either, but I actually have 10 of them here. How convenient that you guys want exactly what I don't know why I collect them. You know, stuff that I don't know why I collect.
Yeah. Shantae is just weird. She's just quirky and weird.
Now we have one missing.
Indeed.
What do you think, the art gallery? Yep. At least they're Squid Baron. Yo.
Good luck. Oh. Hear it.
Velvet poster. Awesome.
Yep.
Thank you.
I know someone who's been asking for one of those. Better head over to Hypno's place and get Abner's poster.
I'm gonna find it a good home with Abner. Are we missing someone?
You know what? After this, you know, we take this back to Squid Baron. He'll give us Risky's buckle. And then after that, we're in kind of a unique situation. Because if we want 100%, we're gonna have to go buy all of the items. That means everything that's left in the item shop. And everything that's left with Tuki. Unfortunately,
okay,
I don't think we've got the money. So what we're going to have to do is get the gem jug dance from Tuki and use that.
That's what I thought too. And so we are now revealing Risky's hideout. We are not going there right now. We're going to Hypno Baron's castle. And we are going to give the poster to Abner. I'm trying to think where is the best place to find what's her name?
Tuki?
The snake girl. Tuki, yeah.
You know, probably the easiest would just be to go to Mermaid Falls and fly up to the top and then to the right, and she's like right there. Or you can do... Oh, no, you got the warp dance. Fuck. Yeah. Mermaid Falls. Just warp twice and you're there. Tasseltown's pretty easy, too, but I would do Mermaid Falls.
There you go. Squeak poster.
It's gonna take...
It's basically infinite money, right? That dance...
It is, but it's not very useful until you have the tiara, which you have, because it
drains. Yeah, that's what I thought. That's why I'm saying it's infinite now, because you don't use magic, right? You can use a spike ball without any problems.
It's gonna take a little
bit.
If you were gonna end the stream, this would be the place to do it, just because the money thing does take a little bit. But other than that.
You know what? We should probably do this in another stream. The only thing I'm going to do for now is go to Mermaid Falls and get that dance just right away. And finish it off with that dance. Yeah, I think that's it's in the next area, right?
It's the third area. Or the fourth area. Because you go to... Or no, the third area. The third. It's like right before you get on the slide.
Can I transport again?
Yeah.
Okay. I don't remember.
Yeah.
Or is that the slide?
Next area after this one.
No, it's a slide. Okay, I can transport there.
Yeah, it's right before the slide. You have to drop down, and she's there in her little pot.
No, I can't skip twice. That's what I'm saying.
Okay,
I can't
well,
do the warp dance twice.
Why are you... that's weird.
It's because it's still the same area. We have to go all the way. So, yeah, that's what I'm going to do.
Oh, well, then just fly up there.
Yeah. So, let's try this again, but this time no warp. Oh, boy. I expected the guy to move faster.
Shantae is going to be on the next episode of Hoarders. don't know, man. She keeps her little lighthouse pretty clean. I would say Shantae.
Yeah, because she never ends up bringing anything home because everybody wants exactly what she just gathers.
Exactly. See, Luigi, she's just like Conker in that everybody's always asking her for favors and shit.
Why am I doing this again? I let me just find a place to fly. I'm dumb.
Yeah, but why are you doing this?
I am too nice with the challenges.
Ooh. Gotta go up there and talk to that motherfucking snake bitch.
I'm gonna kick her face. I was gonna say butt, but I'm not sure if she actually has a butt.
Yeah, I don't think snakes have butts. I mean, do they? Do they have something that would...
If you can find the butt of a snake, let me know.
If you can find it, you can kick it, but I don't know.
Okay, we need the gem jug, so it's a trade.
Oh, look, it is the same. I don't know why I always think of it as a different area. There you go. And you need to give her... I forget. Your warp dance, I think? Yeah. There we go.
Yep.
But that's okay. Dryad is fun. It's pretty useless, but it's fun.
This is and awesome. Jim,
oh, yeah. It's really cool. You're going to have to get a whole bunch of money. And this is not the best place to do it.
No, it's not.
What we're going to ultimately end up doing is you're going to have to buy all the attract spells in Scuttletown, and then we're actually going to go to that fucking tower in Tasseltown and go into one of its little rooms. They're really small, so that each and every little gem piece bounces off and flies back for us.
And this trick doesn't really work. Well, kinda. It's not the worst, but I kinda wanna get enough money to buy the other dance that I didn't buy. But I don't think I'm gonna be lucky with this. How about this?
No, because they shoot out the top.
That's a little bit better if I stand on the top platform. They won't go as far. Well, I think I'm gonna stay there up the rest of the night trying to farm the stuff. See you later. Just kidding. I actually wanted to see if we can collect. It's not a good place to do this, so it's not gonna be effective.
Go to the tower. You can do it in the bathhouse too, but it's not quite as effective as the tower. That's usually where I go. Dude, there have been so many times where, like, you're talking to me, and I'm fucking at this part of the game, just like using the gem jug to get some money. Like, and you don't even know that that's what I'm doing. Like, it takes a good, you know, hour or so.
We're about to end the stream anyway. I'm just gonna get the last transformation I can buy from her. And we're almost there. I need 500, so.
Indeed.
It's almost done. Don't worry, guys.
Well, that's cool. I thought we would actually finish today. That's nice to know there's still one more stream left. Which
it's going to be the
fun.
Finale.
Yeah, we're going to go take
next
down
time,
Race.
Yeah.
Should be a lot of fun, for sure.
It will.
Get a lot of fun up in this, bitch!
Almost there. Done. Exactly 500.
Cool.
Talk to me. Thank you. Super revive dance. I think I got everything except for the potions, which is normal. So, by the way, guys, this is Obliterate. I'm going to show it to you. There you go. It explodes everything. But no enemies on screen, so yep. Oh boy. let's use the warp whistle to warp out of here and save the game. I'm actually going to save the game at in Scuttletown, which I think is going to be the best for us, like usual, you know.
Of course, good old Scuttletown.
Yeah, home sweet home. Home sweet home.
Yeah.
Because we are going to need to collect stuff from here anyway to get the 100%. And I kind of want all the upgrades for the final battle. So we saved, and we're not ready to go. This is the end of this live stream, guys. I'm going to open the chat time with viewers for a little second, and we are going to answer your last questions before we go. And it's pretty much done gameplay-wise. I'll be back in a second, right? Just a second, so we can play the music.
Got it. I'm gonna go fix a cup of tea.
Why do you always talk when this thing is on playing? You should let Blue sing.
Oh, did I interrupt her?
Yes, you did.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, Blue's gonna be sad now.
Yeah.
Hey, no problem.
When she watches this, she's gonna be fucking mad.
Oh, she is. Oh, she is. And about all the artwork at the Discord channel, the Discord chat, where people kept editing her picture.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, that's right.
A
bunch of edits. All right, guys. So it has been Shantae Half-Genie Hero for today. I hope you guys enjoyed. Super Mario fan, yes, you just joined too late. However, I'm up for the questions now, and if you want to ask any questions to me or Juan is not here right now at the second, but he will be back. So anything... Yeah, we are all really kind of rude to Blue, so when she's rude to us, it's understandable. We don't forgive, and we don't forget. We're the most evil people on Earth, so yeah, beware. Awesome. So guys, you guys have been enjoying this. I'm kind of sorry for the, you know, long waiting times and boring stuff. But at the end of the day, it's still complicated, you know. By the way, I'll be right back a second. I won't be long. I am back. I had... Actually, at the beginning of the stream, if you remember, I got a message. My girlfriend is sleeping right now, so... and I had the door open. And I just now saw the message to close the door. She's trying to sleep. I should be more careful. Thank you. I'm glad you enjoyed it. And I'm pretty sure Juan also enjoyed it. Because this game is definitely a blast. And, well, aside from the... You know, the thing with Nega Shantae, the fact that she wasn't included as its own chapter, as her own chapter, was kind of sad. But at the end of the day, it was still a really good reference, which I think it was worth it. To at least have her make an appearance. But oh well.
Oh, Yeah, we didn't think she would because that chapter wasn't funded, you know, so it was quite the surprise when she did in fact show up in the game. I'm glad that they were able to work her in somehow. So, even if it was just for that moment.
I'm not sure if I want to actually try Pac-Man World right now because I already have some games before, but I can look into that for sure. Although I'm not really, you know, I actually play Pac-Man. I have a Pac-Man game. It's Championship Edition, which is awesome, and I would like to play it again, but I'm not going to promise you any game. Ask me later when I have a little bit less games planned, because right now I have a few planned.
Yeah, we've got the queue is pretty full.
Yep.
And just for the record, I requested Half-Genie Hero, but the game was even out.
So yeah, it was yeah.
A long time coming.
I think it was still when I was playing DK64, right?
Yeah, oh yeah. It was, you know what, it was when Luigi guest starred with you.
And, oh, there you go.
And we were just kind of talking about co-hosts and stuff, and, you know, the first thing that popped in my head was like, oh, fuck, you know, we got to do Half-Genie Hero when it comes out. So.
Oh, yeah. And here we are. It's almost done. Jeez, the time just goes. Time just flies. We're already almost done with Shantae. And after Shantae, we are going to have the sequel to 999. So if you're looking forward to see the sequel, it will come out on March, I think, 23rd or 28th. I'm not sure. So I know it's going to come out in the 20th something of March. And once it comes out, I'm going to get it and play it for you guys. But that will give me time to finish Crash to Insanity, I hope. Because I haven't touched that game since. And yeah, I really need to finish that game. I need to find the proper time to record it, and I'm going to try to finish it. And I'm saying I'm going to try to finish it because I haven't felt so motivated to play Crash to Insanity lately. I'm going to be honest here. I like the game overall. I like the game overall, and I think the reception overall was good for being a Crash game, but not good for being the game it was. Right?
You know, it's a cool game.
It's a cool game.
The humor and the writing and all that shit is pretty cool. It's just some of the game design is a little ew.
Yeah, we should definitely see finish that game because after that game, guys, after Crash to Insanity, I am going to play Wario Land: The Shake Dimension.
Oh, shit.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm going to have a t-shirt for the occasion. So be sure to check out the t-shirt selections because we are going to have a little Wario t-shirt.
Wario Land Shake It or Shake Dimension for you Euro people. That game has graphics that are almost as cool as Half-Genie Heroes.
Almost as cool. I think they're pretty much the same kind of style, except for Shantae has a little bit of a 3D effect, while Wario Land The Shake Dimension has straight out 2D graphics. But they look awesome.
Shantae uses a lot of rendered stuff and all that. Which Wario is just straight up, animation, which is really cool. The fact that they did Wario Land like that was so unexpected and so cool.
Is that one good thing about the Wario games is that they always had an appealing style of graphics and music, while also using a really good set of gameplay in the later games. Like Wario Land 4, in my opinion. The controls in that game are so smooth.
Certainly. It's Wario Land 4, I think. A lot of people for some reason start with Wario Land 4, like that's the only one they've played, or that's the first one they've played, or whatever. And it's a good one to start with, definitely, because of that. It's a very well-rounded game.
Yeah, it's definitely.
It's not as, hard, I'll say, as Wario Land 3 is, and I don't know, it's more polished than Wario Land 2, and I don't know, it's a good choice.
Have you seen Boundary Break? You're talking about the show on YouTube, right? I've seen some episodes of it, most of them actually, and I saw the Wario World one, I think, so I like this that one too. Did you see that, Juan, the Boundary Break show on YouTube?
I don't even know what it is.
It's basically the dude that actually explores everything outside the boundaries of the game, so basically... going through the walls and checking the world outside with different camera angles, and you see really interesting stuff where some models are stored, some levels are designed, how how the loading zones work in Metroid Prime and stuff like that. That's really cool.
You know, that sounds actually pretty interesting. I thought it was going to be some other chump on YouTube. But sounds pretty cool.
Exactly. It's actually a really good way to show you that games actually work the same way as movies do, in which what's on camera is what you get.
That's it.
Yeah, that's all.
Certainly.
And everything is backstage and everything is hidden. Yeah.
There's a lot more in common than it might seem at first.
Yeah, exactly. And there's also one of the YouTubers I don't remember. He's quite popular, this one, when it comes to Paper Mario, which I've been looking at his videos, how to glitch Paper Mario and find different ways to glitch the game. And some little sections of the game show some characters being stored outside of the level. That's awesome, too. You can see plenty of stuff that have been tweaked in a way that the game works and... And it's basically the backstage of the whole game. You can see some characters there, preloaded. It's awesome. Backst- it's really awesome. It's a lot of curiosity in that aspect. It's really, really nice to check out how they did the game, how they worked on it, what were they actually thinking during the development of certain levels of games. That's awesome.
You know, the backstage metaphor actually really works for Paper Mario. What is it? Thousand Year Door is like all on a stage. It's like a play.
The Thousand Year Door, all the battles are a play. The battles are, which is awesome. It's actually one of my favorite mechanics of the game, having the crowd. It's so much a good something that I really like that I actually incorporated in with my remake of the music, the battle music. I incorporated the claps, which is like support Mario. You can hear the crowd clap for Mario.
Yeah, totally. Paper Mario was always so innovative in those ways. Just fun little ways to kind of keep you in the game and all that shit. Now it's just about Toads.
The games are awesome. They just lack imagination in terms of character. They lack character. Yeah.
Which is such a shame because the earlier games had so much character. My God, some of the best Mario character designs I've ever seen came from Thousand Year Door and the first game. And it was really a shame.
It was. There were titles, I think, made the first two. I'm not sure about Super Paper Mario, but the first two were developed by Intelligent Systems, which is noted for making really cool titles and simplistic ones too. Simple ideas, new ideas. They always brought something new to the table. They're good. I like Intelligent Systems for that.
Indeed, they are. I think best known for. Well, for Paper Mario, but also for Fire Emblem. They do Fire Emblem.
Yep.
They did Game & Wario, if anybody likes that.
It's not a bad game, it's just a one-time thing, you know?
Yeah. Advance Wars, and they did some earlier stuff too. But yeah, they're a pretty heavy Nintendo developer.
Indeed.
Definitely one to respect. Who the hell does Paper Mario now? Is it just in-house at Nintendo?
Sorry?
Who the hell develops Paper Mario now? Is it just in-house?
I'm not certain. I'm not sure. I'd have to check that out.
Shit. Because whoever's doing it...
So apparently Luigi Rock says that... Luigi Rock says that all the games were intelligent systems.
Well, really?
Yeah, including Super Paper Mario.
I figured that one was because it had a original cool story.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's awesome. Damn... I mean, it's cool that they've remained the developer. I just wouldn't like to see them go away, but my God, they need to... Honestly, in this case, I love Miyamoto. I think he's a national treasure. International treasure. He's a genius and all this other great shit I can say about him. But he needs to fuck off with Paper Mario, okay?
Definitely.
He needs to fuck right off.
Yeah, he keeps too much of what he created, of what is Nintendo's. And doesn't live too much. He doesn't let developers use their imagination a little bit more, which is why the latest titles were restrained.
Yeah, exactly. You know, he's the one who put a stop to all those interesting character designs. So,
by the way, just because I saw that in the chat, I'm not ignoring. J-Rod says that Blue's take, actually, yeah, Blue does the music on the channel. So Blue's take on Trainer Red's theme was awesome. And that's what got him or her into the channel. And that is exactly what I wanted to ask you guys. What brought you here? Was it the music, the games? What was it? Also, Leonard, I remember you commenting for the first time on the Final Fantasy VII battle theme that I have on the channel. Thank you, guys, for staying in the channel after those fantastic musics. And I hope you had time to get there and listen to the others. Check out other stuff. Because I've been working, I have 1,000-something videos on the channel, so there's plenty to watch. If I'm not uploading, you still have stuff to catch up on, I'm pretty sure.
Indeed. I think actually the first how I even got involved in all this was Color Splash. I think I talked about this last stream.
Yep, so I actually remember that you joined through Color Splash.
Yeah.
And it's actually the stream parts, the stream of the channel that got you into the channel, right?
It is. You know, we're both members of Wario Forums. So I knew that you were doing streams. I didn't pay much mind to them until one day I did and, you know, kept coming back.
Yeah. Definitely. And I know also there's a lot of people that follow the channel since the outburst of the Warland 4 remakes. A lot of people got into the channel thanks to the Warland 4 album that I made last year, I think. Last year, yeah.
There was a little bit of that, definitely.
Yeah. It was Color Splash too, yeah, Luigi. Yeah, it was definitely Color Splash. A lot of people joined with Color Splash. A lot of people joined with Warland 4. And I have another few people that joined because of the Bowser remixes. I remember that. A lot of people liked the Bowser themes that I remixed. When I say I remixed, I say Blue, of course. But yeah,
Definitely. I remember when you did Ao Oni on Halloween. That was like so
much.
Oh,
yeah, yeah. That was actually innovative because I never played a game made by... well, how do you consider that? Indie game, maybe? Not even.
Yeah.
An RPG Maker game.
Yeah.
You know, I never played a small game. That's what I'm trying to say. A small... I actually played some games that were made by smaller smaller companies, but never by a person or two, you know?
Oh, yeah. As far as, you know, RPG Maker games go, that's probably one of the bigger ones. I was definitely psyched that you picked that for the Halloween game. I thought it would be great, like a super cool thing to have streamed, and you picked it. So it was great.
So I actually expected Luigi's Mansion to take all 3 days. And at the same time, seeing the rate as the first was going, I actually expected probably to finish the game in that same day. And having time to have 3 games for one for each day. Well, as it turned out, 2 days were filled with Luigi's Mansion, and then Halloween night was filled with Ao Oni, which actually was quite fitting.
It was pretty perfect.
And we were able to finish it all that day, which was awesome too. Because usually these games could take some time if you try to figure everything out.
I was definitely surprised. Back when I played it, I did not finish it nearly as quickly as you did.
I'm smart. Did you see how well I tackled 999? I'm quite impressed with myself.
Well, then why do you suck at Shantae so much?
Because
no shit about gene magic.
No, Shantae always challenged me. Every single platformer that has a challenge really always challenged me a lot. It doesn't need to be hard mode. It's straight up like... Shantae is a really hard, difficult series, you know, to tackle on. If you're not a pro and if you're not good at platforming, this is going to be a challenge for you, definitely. And you have to think outside the box and use the transformations to your advantage to get past those levels, like I did, because I suck at platforming, but they're my favorite type of games.
Sure.
Has got her revenge. He's bad a chance because Risky's got her revenge. That's nice.
No kidding. But yeah, Shantae, it's definitely made for gamers. You know, it doesn't pull its punches. I think people look at it and they see this cute genie and they think like, oh, this will be a walk in the park. But it's really not. I mean, it's a challenging game when it wants to be, and I don't know.
Definitely.
It's definitely, as a platformer, it stands right up there with the best of them, for sure. And that's
definitely,
why Shantae.
Definitely.
And she's also the greatest character ever conceived.
I don't know about that.
Well, then let's agree to disagree.
We know exactly who's the best character ever invented.
Shantae?
She's right in front of your screen.
I know.
So better say she is, or else she'll go to your home and destroy you. You might not wake up the next morning.
Do I want to wake up next morning? I don't know.
If you're actually dreaming of genies, I'm pretty sure you won't.
Oh, that's true.
You'll stay in the genie world for a little bit more.
Yeah. Never see Shantae again if I don't wake up, or if I don't wait.
Wait. Yeah, that's
pretty cool. How about that?
There you go. That's a lot better. I'm pretty sure she'll appreciate those words. and you know what? She might spare you. I'm picturing Blue as a killer.
Hey man, I made that really cool SMB2 style sprite of her. I mean, fuck.
Oh yeah. And I love actually the death sprite that you made. It's awesome. All of them are awesome, but that one is really cool.
Yeah, I was kind of proud about that. I knew when I was making that you'd like that one for sure.
Yeah. All right. Metal Sonic, if you want to use this time to ask, you can go ahead, or else you can also use the Discord, and that's not only for you but everybody else who wants to join the Discord chat and have a little chat outside the streams, you know, and chill out. It's also more to chill out and meet new people, so
yeah.
Definitely consider joining in. Where have you been? Who?
Who are you talking to? Me? Or Jack? Or PJ? Probably PJ, huh? Or no? Yeah? Maybe? Blue? I don't know.
Blue actually has been working on her own album for quite a while, and she's having a writer's block, so it's not really easy for her right now. The album she's trying to work on is going to be on her own channel. Make sure to check that out when it comes out.
Oh, yeah. When is Blue's channel? Is there going to be a Blue Discord, too, or are we keeping that on the same?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
GS Shantae is talking to you right now, and he is the co-commentator.
Yeah, JS stands for Juan Schwartz. So it's that's me. But yeah, I'm can't wait for that channel, Blue channel.
Yeah.
I'm always consistently impressed with what Blue makes. So
we'll see. Some ideas were scrapped, and she's kind of struggling with it. Let's give her some courage. She'll do it. Inspiration will come.
Yeah, well, it happens. You know, any good artist. Sometimes Shantae, you know, she can't think up any new cool dance moves. You know. That's an art.
Yeah, there you go. Dancing is an art.
Yeah, she's a fabulous
artist. And transforming
art.
While dancing, and dancing for transformation is also an art.
Yeah, and she has to be super careful to not transform while she's dancing if she doesn't want to. Like, if she's on stage just going at it, she don't want to turn into an elephant.
Oh, or a poo. You never saw Shantae transform into a poo. It can happen.
It would be the most adorable poop ever, but, you know. I was thinking about that the other day. I was like, dude, like, you could slap the eyes, like the face on the gem jug, like you could take that and put it on like a turd, like a pile of shit, and it would be fucking adorable. It's like it doesn't matter what form she's in, you know, she's wonderful.
it's Shantae, whatever form.
It's like adorable. Dude, anything. It's just Shantae, you know. She's just immaculate.
Definitely. All right then. Well, if you have any more questions to ask, go ahead. If not, we are going to end the stream for today. I think it's a good stream overall, and next time we're ready to go for the ending of the game. And I'll see if I can play some Crash to Insanity in between, which I've been missing out on that. But yeah, don't worry. It's not over yet.
Indeed. Next episode, we're gonna go take on the wretched boots. Fuck her
and
shit.
And we still have one item left to collect out of the four. And it's exactly what we're gonna do. Give the poster to to Abner and get another poster back? That's what you said?
Yeah, he's going to give us one and we take that back to Squid Baron.
Yep, there you go. And we're going to get the last... the last item for to go check Risky. PJ, see you in the Discord and the forums, Wario forums, guys. Wario forums. Don't forget to check it out if you're a fan of Wario. And even if you're not, and you like something related to Wario or has Wario in it, don't forget to check to speak your experience with us and go there to the Wario forums. Don't forget about that because we're there too. Both of us.
Yeah.
So yeah, definitely go there.
Definitely. You know, we have a few people there that really aren't that into Wario, and they still, you know, they still hang out there daily. It's still a pretty cool place. We just happen to be big Wario fans.
Definitely.
So it's, yeah, even better for us, but you don't have to be. I think I'm going to go there now. Goodbye, everyone. It's always a pleasure.
Goodbye. Goodbye, everyone. Thank you for coming once again, Mr. Juan, and I will see you guys in the next stream. All right?
Thank you. I'm ready to leave.
I call this a success. Have a wonderful night. Bye-bye.